Hi, I'm Ryan. I work in the media industry and I've lived in China for almost 4 years now. 2021 marks the 100th anniversary of the founding of the Communist Party of China. And during those 100 years, its members have grown from a few dozen to over 95 million strong. Living in China, some of my friends and colleagues are party members. Now you might be curious, what exactly are these people like? So to help you get a better understanding, I've invited other foreigners who also live in China to go and visit young party members through various careers in an attempt to paint a clearer picture by better getting to know their life and their work. We hope to discover who these people really are. And I personally hope that these experiences help foreigners in China and abroad better understand this country and its people.
I'm Nicola and I come from Switzerland. When I heard I was going to interview a member of the Chinese Communist Party, I asked some friends about what's their view about this topic. This made me realize the gap between the reality and some of their impression. Both my mother and sister are teachers in Switzerland. So today, let's go to a public elementary school in Beijing and meet Mrs. Cui, who is both a member of the party and a head teacher. Let's learn about her, her school, and try to understand what it means to be a member of the party in modern China. Head teacher.
A position with Chinese characteristic in school. The teacher takes care of almost everything related to his or her student at school.
有这个班主任啊，其实是一个非常涵盖很多很多的这样的一个概念。
你看，整整齐齐，对吧？口罩也戴好了，衣服也穿好了，得以彰表扬他，特别棒。
红一定要把它写长，而且是在红中线起笔。
从七点进校那一刻开始，基本上就停不下来。因为孩子小，一年级嘛，所以早上起来您可能会看到，我们一边这边给孩子培养吃饭，就是培养他们用餐的这个习惯。桌面是怎么摆？比如说这个铅笔要放在哪儿？
尺子要放在哪儿？班主任是一直有的，因为这是咱们中国的一个固定的这么一个模式。班主任也管着这一班的大事小情啊，他管孩子们的在学校的这个学习生活，管他们的身体健康，管他们的安全，甚至管家庭矛盾，指导孩子如何文明的吃饭，文明的如厕，文明的在楼道里行进，怎么跟老师打招呼啊，怎么待人接物呢？
其实跟父母是差不多的。老师，介绍一下我们今天的这位大朋友，同时也是咱们这一节课的同学。
Among Mrs. Cui's students, I noticed several overseas pupils. This is Song Weiro, whose parents are Hungarian, working in Beijing. Like other students in the class, she's wearing a red scarf, the symbol of young pioneers, as I know. Which arose my curiosity.
This is to give your younger brothers and sisters an example. So I also want to join the first-line and wear a beautiful red scarf.
We just thought she could fit, so when we were holding her, we put her on. Later that day, I suddenly thought, she's not Chinese citizen. Her parents are not Chinese people. 那他入少先队，我们会想到，人家父母同不同意？妈妈非常支持，她说：“要是我们可以吗？”她说：“如果我们可以的话，我特别希望他也能带上红领巾。”然后呢，学校就决定可以，既然是他迫切希望，学校就决定吸收他为少先队队员。那天在这个入队仪式啊，特别的开心。
什么都可以做了，比如说像什么桌子呀、椅子呀，对，这都是学生自己的作品。
中国本身就是一个很开放很包容的一个国家，所以在教育上呢也是这样的，别的哪个国家的有好的做法好的经验我们都会给他借鉴过来，然后去学习，然后用在我们自己的教育上，让中国的孩子让他成长的让他视野更宽阔，让他能力更强，将来等到他们长大了的时候像我们一样坐在一起沟通啊了解的时候，让很多的国家和中国之间的这种友谊让它更牢固。
I'm quite surprised at how easy it is for me to get along with all the kids here. I don't feel any cultural difference or any barriers at all.
To my surprise, compared with the number of classrooms for Chinese, mathematics, foreigner language course, there are more activity rooms set up to cultivate students' passion and interest in Mr. Sui's school.
Hello. How are you?
I told my elder sister, who is also a teacher back in Switzerland, about this discovery, and she was so curious about it.
And it's a powder, I'm not sure what this is. I press it, oh, to make small, they make small balls of it.
对，
那我可以吃吗？
可以啊，
就这样。
这是热乎的，趁热吃。
Very good， 谢谢。
味道怎么样？
哎，right is good。
What interests me more is that discipline and lively, which are two seemingly contradictory objectives, can be used together to describe Mrs. Sui's class and even the whole school.
So right now you can listen, there is many noise, children playing around. And the reason is not they are having the sport class now, but in the afternoon to clear their mind, they are having some games. So let's join them and do some activities.
Andy 刚才他就跑三十次啊，三十次，备，走。
The class advisor seems to have much work to do. Besides tutoring students, they play games with them.While playing together, I can feel the student's delight and their love for their teacher. From the perspective of an outsider, the interaction between Mrs. Sui and her student show that they have a high degree of trust and a close relation with each other. And this could not be set up in a short time.
现在这个世界这样运动不是体育老师来教，就是为什么是你来的？
这个时间我们叫体育锻炼时间，那它不是正规的体育课程，班主任跟孩子一起练，对于班集体的这个
团队
精神，对。然后当班主任融在里边，也可以看到孩子非常开心。我们希望多一点时间能够跟孩子这样亲密的接触，
但是也这样有一个缺点，老师会累。
可能这个累完了之后会感到很舒服。
跳，
一个，
跳，
两个，
跳，
三个，
跳，
四个，
跳。
有些时候孩子他会不自觉的走着，因为他跟妈妈比较亲近嘛，他在上学的时候他也会不自觉的走过来，妈妈，就会这样叫你，然后一愣，然后他说，哦，不对不对，崔老师，就是这样的。
When it comes to her relationship with students, 3 years ago, Mrs. Sui elaborated a book signing ceremony for one of her students. There must be extreme care, love and patience.So that a teacher in charge of more than 30 students and being busy with daily affairs can notice the talents and characteristics of one child in a certain field.
刚开始就是孩子随手画的，一张一张连续起来的，然后家长呢也没有意识到这是一个什么绘本啊，就把它拍成了图片发到朋友圈上，然后我就看到了，我说这不就是一本书吗？我说既然这是你的第一本书哈，也是你的处女作，我们就开一个这个新书的这样一个签赠会。那件事之后，他上初一的第一个这个教师节也是给我发来了信息，他说这么普通的一个行为会引起这么大的反响，我们不能光教好这点课，学好这点知识，还要真要关注孩子的心理以及他生活的一些细节和点滴。
After introducing the daily routine of the school, let's come back to the most concern and core question. What does the identity of a CPC member mean to Mrs. Sui? There are many head teachers like Mrs. Sui in the school. They all have similar work, content and responsibilities. So, Does the identity of a CPC member make her different from the other teacher? How does she see her dual identities of a CPC member and a teacher?
我不知道国外人是怎么理解咱们党员啊，但是呢，他却这个身份给你之后，他是无形的在告诉你，这个时候就得有你，关键的时候你就得上，没有理由，责无旁贷。比如说我为人民服务，对吧？他就不是一句空话，他真的是这样做的。我怎么为人民服务？也许我就是我让我班孩子多喝点水，不生病。我为人民服务，我多跟家长沟通一下，提早解决家长的问题。我觉得这区别于你对这个事情你投入了多少，你是不是用心了。
After spending some time in Miss Choi's class and talking with her, we can see she is a passionate teacher. Although she is taking her responsibility very seriously, she is also very easygoing with her student. But what I can see is a teacher who cares and loves her student. Everyone may have their own different understanding of what it means to be in the party. But let's not forget that behind this label, they are just ordinary people.
同学们再见，
老师再见，谢谢老师，
别放你，
拜拜。